Welcome back. In our earlier video, we had discussed about the meaning of total shareholder returns, how to calculate the annual total shareholder returns, and the factors driving the returns. We got follow-up questions on how do we calculate the total shareholder return if the holding period of the share or security is more than 1 year. In this video, we will discuss how to calculate total return to shareholders or total shareholder returns if the investment period is more than 1 year. Let us look with the help of a simple example. So here we have share price of a company from 31st December 2015 to 31st December 2020. This company hasn't paid any dividend during this period. So, just to recap, total shareholder returns is driven by two factors. The one is the capital appreciation with the increase in the share prices, and second is the dividend yield. So, in this case, we will calculate both the share price appreciation and dividend yield. So, share price appreciation is the share price during the closing period minus share price at the start of the period. So, that gives us the share price change divided by the share prices at the start of the period. So, in the year 2016, if someone invested in this stock at $110 on 31st December 2015, so the share price appreciation from 31st December 2015 to 31st December 2016 was 4.5%. We will calculate the share price appreciation for each year. To calculate the share price appreciation, we will select the range and then press F2 and then Control and Enter. So the share price appreciation in the first year was 4.5%. In the second year, the share prices declined from $115 to $90. So that is a negative 21.7% shareholder return. In the third year, the share prices increased from 90 to 120. So it's a 33% appreciation. Similarly, 12.5% and 8.9%. In the fourth and fifth year. The dividend yield is calculated as dividend paid during the period, which is zero in this case, divided by the share price at the beginning of the period. The dividend yield is zero, but to calculate for all the periods, we'll select the range, press F2, and then Control and Enter. Dividend yield is zero. Now, total shareholder return is share price change, which is 4.5% plus dividend yield. The total shareholder return is 4.5% in year 1. And similarly, if we press F2 and Control and Enter, we get the shareholder return for each period. Now, to calculate the year-on-year TSR, we'll use the geomean function in Excel. To use the geomean function, type is equal to geomean 1 plus, select the range, close the bracket, and then minus 1, and then press Control Shift and Enter. So the total shareholder return for this company during the period of 5 years is 6%. We can also calculate it with a different formula. So, there is an alternate way to calculate the shareholder return when there is no dividend payment. So, if someone invested $110 on 31st December 2015, that investment became $147 in year 2020. So, we can just calculate the compounded annual growth rate, which is 147, the closing share price divided by the share price at the start of the period, to the power 1 by 5, because we are calculating the returns for 5 years, minus 1. and then press enter. So we get the same answer using this formula, but this formula can only be used when there is just the share price increase or decrease and no dividend payment. In this case, the total shareholder return is just the share price appreciation, which is 6% on an annualized basis for the last 5 years. Moving to the second example, so here we have a company where we have the share price at the end of each year from 2015 to 2020. This company has also paid dividends during each year. So again, we will calculate the TSR on a year-on-year basis, which is sum of the capital appreciation, which is share price change, and dividend yield. So let's quickly do this. So share price appreciation is share price at the end of the period minus share price at the beginning of the period divided by share price at the beginning of the period. So it's 4.5%. Dividend yield is the dividend paid during the year divided by share prices at the start of the year. So it's 5.5%. And total shareholder return is the sum of capital appreciation and the dividend yield. So the total shareholder return in the year 2016 is 10%. So likewise, we'll calculate the TSR for each year. So first, for the share price change, we'll select the range and then press F2 and then Control and Enter. For the dividend yield, again, press F2 and then Control and Enter. And TSR is just the sum of these two. Press F2, Control and Enter. So we get the TSR on a year-on-year basis. To calculate it for the period of 5 years, we can do it again by two methods. First is by using the geo mean function in Excel. So we can use by typing is equal to geo mean 1 plus select the range, the TSR range for the entire period, minus 1, and then since it's an array function, press Control Shift and Enter. So the TSR for this company is 13.3%. We can calculate the TSR with an alternate method also. So suppose you have invested $100 in this company on 31st December 2015. This investment becomes 100 multiplied by 1 plus the TSR during 2016, that is $110 in 2016. And likewise, if we press F2 and Control and Enter, so we see that $100 invested on 31st December 2015 became $186.3 on 31st December 2020. Now we can calculate the annualized TSR. So annualized TSR is the value of the investment at the end of the period divided by the value of investment at the start of the period to the power 1 by the number of years, which is the 5 years, minus 1, and then enter. So we get the same answer. The TSR for this company is 13.3%. So this is the way how we can calculate the TSR if the holding period of the security is more than 1 year. Hope you enjoyed this session. If you like this video, please share it with your friends and colleagues. And also, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and like this video. Thank you.